Come and abide in us, cleanse us from every stain, and save our souls, O Lord. Holy God, O God, according to thy great goodness, we pray thee, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for all pious and orthodox Christians.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for our Father and Metropolitan Joseph.
Salvation is not as though that I hope the Lord will help me. O Lord, forgive me not in thine anger, chase me in thy wrath. For thine arrows are fast in me, not like thy hand have laid upon me. There is no healing in my flesh in the face of thy wrath, and there is no peace in my bones in the face of my sin. For my iniquities have risen higher than my head, as I have burned my throat in my body. My dreams have become noise and felt in the face of my folly. I have been rushed and unto God down to the end, all the days of my life without past faith. For my loins are filled with wine, and there is no healing in my flesh. I have afflicted and humbled exceedingly, and I roared and adorned with my heart. O Lord, before thee shall my desire and my groaning is not hidden from me. My heart is troubled, my strength is filled, and the light of my eyes even this is not with me. My friends and my neighbors do not reach out to me and stood, and my neighbors have kids to the far off. The day that set out against our youth violence, and that saw people to me speak great things and practice all the day long in the meditate. For I am ready for the scourge of my sorrows continue before me. For I will defend my enemies and I will take heed to my sin. But my enemies live and make stronger than I, they that behave me unjustly multiply. They that threaten me evil will go slander me because of which is goodness. Forsake me not, O Lord my God, depart not from me, be attentive unto my help, O Lord of my salvation. Forsake me not, O Lord my God, depart not from me, be attentive unto my help, O Lord of my salvation. O God my God, unto thee arose early at dawn. My soul has thirsted for thee, how often hath my flesh longed after thee when I am barren and torn and tortured. So on this end shall appear before thee to see thy power of my glory. For thy mercy is greater than life, and I shall praise thee. So shall I bless in my life, and thy name will lift up my hands. As the marrow fattens, let my soul be filled with lips joyful, shall I not praise thee. The upright member thee on my bed, and on that is my deep, thou dost become my helper. In the shelter of thy wings will I rejoice. My soul hath leaped after thee, and thy right hand hath been quick to help me. But as for these men and as after my soul, which shall go down into the nethermost parts of the earth. They shall be smitten unto them as a sword, portions of the cross shall they be. But the king shall be glad in God, and everyone shall be praised and glorify him. For the mouth of them shall be free from unjust things. At the dawn of night, and I'll leave the dog become my helper. In the shelter of thy wings will I rejoice. My soul has believed after thee, and thy right hand hath been quick to help me.
Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Both now and ever, and unto ages and ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Both now and ever, and unto ages and ages. Amen. O Lord God, my salvation, if I day have I cried my night before thee, let my prayer come before thee, thou bountifully appear unto my supplication. Fulfill the evils of my soul, and my life unto Hades hath drawn nigh. I count with them and go down into the pit, and become a man without help, free among the dead, like the bodies of the slain that sleep in the grave, and now remembrest no more. And they are cut off from thy hand, and laid me in the lowest pit, in darkness and in the shadow of death. Against me is thine anger made strong, and all thy billows hast thou brought upon me. Thou hast removed my friends afar from me. They have made me an abomination unto themselves. I have been delivered up and have not performed. Mine eyes have grown weak with poverty. I have cried unto thee, O Lord, my God, and all. I have stretched out my hands unto thee. Nay, for the dead wilt thou work wonders, or shall physicians raise them up that they may give thanks unto thee? Nay, shall any of the grave tell of thy mercy, and thy truth and thy destruction? Nay, shall thy wonders be known in thy darkness, and thy righteousness in that land that is forgotten. But as for me and to thee, O Lord, I have cried, and in the morning shall my prayer come before thee. Wherefore, O Lord, dost thou cast off my soul and turn thy face away from me? A poor man am I, and in troubles from my youth. Yea, having been exalted, I was humbled and brought to distress. Thy furies have passed upon me, and thy terrors have sorely troubled me. They came round about me like water, all the day long they compassed me about together. Thou hast removed afar from me friend and neighbor and mine acquaintances because of my misery. O Lord, God of my salvation, by day have I cried, by night before thee. Let my prayer come before thee, bow down thine ear unto my supplication. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within thee, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all that he hath done for thee. Who is gracious unto all thine iniquities, who healeth all thine infirmities, who redeemeth thy life from corruption, who crowneth thee with mercy and compassion, who fulfilleth thy desire with good things, that you shall be renewed as the eagles, The Lord performeth deeds of mercy and executeth judgment for all them that are wrong. He hath made his ways known unto Moses and to the sons of Israel the things that he hath willed. Compassionate and merciful is the Lord, long suffering and plenteous in mercy. Not unto the end will he be angered, neither unto eternity will he be wroth. Not according to our iniquities hath he dealt with us, neither according to our sins hath he rewarded us. For according to the height of heaven and the earth, the Lord hath made his mercy to prevail over them that fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far hath he removed our iniquities from us. Like as a father hath compassion upon his sons, so hath the Lord had compassion upon them that fear him. For he knoweth whereof they are made, yet remember that we are dust. As for man, his days are as the grass, as the plow of the field, so shall he blossom forth. But when the wind is passed over, then it shall be gone, and the long will not know the place thereof. But the mercy of the Lord is from eternity, even unto eternity, upon them that fear him. And his righteousness is upon the sons of his sons, upon them that keep his testament and remember his commandments to do them. The Lord in heaven hath prepared his throne, and his kingdom ruleth over all. Bless the Lord, O ye his angels, mighty in strength, that perform his word, to hear the voice of his words. Bless the Lord, O ye his hosts, his ministers that do his will. Bless the Lord, O ye his works, in every place of his dominion. Bless the Lord, O my soul. In every place of his dominion, bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord, hear my prayer, give ear unto my supplication and my truth. Hearken unto me in my righteousness, and enter not into judgment with thy servant, for in thy sight shall no man living be justified. For the enemy hath persecuted my soul, he hath humbled my life down to the earth, he hath sat me in darkness as those who have been long dead, and my spirit within me has become despondent. Within me my heart is troubled. I remember the days of old, I meditated on all thy works, I pondered on the creations of thy hands. I stretched forth my hands unto thee, my soul thirsted after thee like a waterless nymph. Quickly hear me, O Lord, as a fear and fainted away. Turn not thy face away from me, lest I be like one of them, like unto them that go down into the pit. Cause me to hear thy mercy in the morning, for me have I been my hope. Cause me to know, O Lord, the way wherein I should walk, for to thee have I lifted up my soul. Rescue me from my enemies, O Lord, and to thee have I fled for refuge. Teach me to do thy will, and thou art my good God. That your good spirit shall lead me in the land of uprightness. And thy namesake, O Lord, shall thou lead me. In thy righteousness shalt thou bring my soul out of affliction, and in thy mercy shalt thou utterly destroy mine enemies. And thou shalt cut off all that lifteth my soul, for I am thy servant. O Lord, give ear to my supplication, and enter not into judgment with thy servant. O Lord, give ear unto my supplication, and enter not into judgment with thy servant. Thy good spirit shall lead me in the land of uprightness. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the Lord, and to the Lord, and to the Lord. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. O God, and our hope, glory to thee.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord. From above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house, and for those who enter with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our Father and Metropolitan Joseph, the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Metropolitan Paul, Archbishop John, for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord. For the President of the United States and all civil authorities, and for our armed forces everywhere, especially Peter, Ronnie, Andrew, Joshua, Connor, Skyler, Benjamin, Thaddeus, and Adam, let us pray to the Lord. For this city, for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, And for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and their salvation, and especially for those suffering for the faith, let us pray to the Lord. For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and need, help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Calling to remembrance our all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
For unto thee are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
God is the Lord, you
Christ our God.
Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Seal thy tomb, O Savior, and the angels did roll the stone from off thy grave, and the women witnessed thy resurrection from the dead. They proclaimed to thy disciples in Zion that thou didst rise the life of all, and didst break asunder the bonds of death, O Lord, glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Verily, when the women came with their ointment, they heard from the grave an angelic voice saying, cease your tears and receive joy instead of sorrow. And
cry and pray
that Christ the Lord is
and
be God and
be pleased
to save mankind.
But now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. Verily all creation rejoices in thee, O full of grace. The assembly of angels and the races of men, O holy temple and paradise endowed with speech, the pride of virginity from whom God was incarnate and became a child, being yet our God before the ages. For he hath made thy receptacle a throne, and thy womb more spacious than the heavens. Wherefore, full of grace, the whole creation rejoices in thee and glorifies thee.
We adore.
us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in your remembrance, our all holy immaculate, most blessed and glorious, may be a focus never, Virgin Mary. With all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life to you, Christ our God.
Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, who are now, ever, and into the ages of ages. Amen.
Verily, the Holy Spirit all shall live, and he is the light of life, and great God, let us ever praise him, the Father, and the Lord.
Yea, let my humble heart be lighted by thy fear, lest it rise and fall from thee, all compassionate one.
He that trusteth in the Lord shall not fear, and God shall judge all which will empty fire.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, who are now, ever, and into the ages of ages. Amen.
Verily, by the Holy Spirit, every divine one seeth and uttereth things to be, and performeth heavenly wonders, for he seeth to one God is three. For the Godhead, albeit of three lights, is one in leadership.
But even I cry, O Lord, listen and turn thine ear toward me when I shout. Purify me before thou raisest me from this place.
Verily, everyone shall return and disappear in his mother the earth, and shall be dissolved at once to receive either honors or punishments as reward for what they have done in this lifetime.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and in the ages of ages.
Verily, to the Holy Spirit, one speaketh of the bride, the one of the Christ holy, for from the Father, who was without beginning, the Son did proceed without time. And the Spirit, who is their equal in appearance on the throne, hath shone forth from the Father likewise.
Behold, how good and how beautiful for the brethren to live together. For of this the Lord promised eternal life.
Verily, he who beautifieth the flower of the field commandeth that no one take heed for his dross.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, who are now ever and in the ages of ages. Amen.
Verily, the Holy Spirit is the cause of all, and containeth in himself the harmony of safety. For he is truly equal to the Father and the Son in substance.
Everything that hath breath,
worthy to hear the Holy Gospel, let us pray to the Lord God.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom attend, let us hear the Holy Gospel.
Peace be to all. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee.
Let us attend.
At that time, Mary stood weeping outside the tomb, and as she wept, she stooped to look into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white sitting where the body of Jesus had lain, one at the head and one at the feet. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "Because they have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." Saying this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing, but she did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom do you seek?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not hold me, for I have not yet ascended to my Father. But go to my brethren and say to them, I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene went and said to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord." And she told him that he has said these things to her.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee.
We have beheld the resurrected Christ. Let us bow down before the Lord Jesus, the only sinless one. Thy cross to be adored of Christ, thy holy resurrection to be raised and glorified. For thou art our God, and we know none other beside thee. We call upon thy name. O come, mighty faithful, let us adore Christ's holy resurrection. For lo, through the cross, joy is coming to all the world. Ever blessing the Lord, let us sing his resurrection. For in that he endured the cross for us, we have destroyed death by death.
Have mercy on me, O God, according to thy great mercy, according to the multitude of my compassions, blot out my transgressions. Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my iniquity, and my sin is ever before me. Against thee only have I sinned and done this evil before thee, that thou mightest be justified in thy words, and prevail when thou art judged. For behold, I was conceived in iniquities, and in sins did my mother bear me. For behold, thou hast loved truth, but hidden in secret things of thy wisdom hast thou made manifest unto me. Thou shalt sprinkle me with hyssop, and I shall be made clean. Thou shalt wash me, and I shall be made whiter than snow. Thou shalt make me hear joy and gladness, the bones that the humble face shall rejoice. Turn thy face away from my sins, and blot out all my iniquities. Create me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and with thy governing spirit establish me. I shall teach transgressors thy ways, and the ungodly shall be turned back unto thee. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God, thou God of my salvation. My tongue shall rejoice in thy righteousness. O Lord, thou shalt open my lips, and my mouth shall declare thy praise. For thou hadst desired sacrifice, and I give it. With whole offering thou shalt not be pleased. A sacrifice unto God is a broken spirit, a heart that is broken and humble, God will not despise. Do good, O Lord, and I give pleasure in Zion. Let the walls of Jerusalem be built up. And they shall be pleased with the sacrifice of righteousness, with oblation and whole burnt offering, then they shall offer bullocks upon that altar.
Thank you.
O God, save thy people and bless thine inheritance. Bless thy world with mercy and compassion. Exalt, O Lord of Orthodox Christians, send down upon us thy rich mercies. Through the intercessions of our all immaculate Lady Theotokos, never Virgin Mary, by the might of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, and the supplications of thy honorable and glorious prophet, former Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, all lovable apostles, Peter and Paul, and of all thy holy apostles, of our fathers among the saints, great hierarchs and ecumenical teachers, Basil the Great, Gregory the Theologian, and John Chrysostom, Athanasius, Cyril, and John the Merciful, Patriarch of Alexandria, Nicholas of Myra, Spiridon of Prometheus, Nectarius of Pentapolis, the Wonder Workers, of our fathers among the saints, Tikhon, Patriarch of Moscow, Raphael, Bishop of Brooklyn, of the holy, glorious, great martyrs, George the Trophy Bearer, Demetrius the Merce Streamer, Theodore the Soldier, Theodore the General, and Minos the Wonder Worker, of the higher martyrs, Ignatius the God Bearer of Antioch, Arlampos, Eleutherios, of the holy, glorious, great women martyrs, Thecla, Barbara, Anastasia, Catherine, Kiriaki, Fatini, Marina, Prescovina, Irene, of the holy, glorious, right, victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, who shone in the ascetic life, Saint Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of our venerable and God-bearing father, John Clemens of Sinai, author of the latter, of our fathers among the saints, Cyril, patriarch of Jerusalem, the martyrs, Trophimus, Carpos of Nicomedia, and of those with them, Nicholas, Bishop of Zika, who labored in America, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all thy saints, we beseech thee, O most merciful Lord, hearken unto the petitions of us sinners who make our supplications unto thee, have mercy upon us. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and save us.
Celebration of his feast on this day arose from the custom prevalent in the honorable monasteries of starting Great Lent with the reading of his lessons. John describes the method of elevating the soul to God as ascending a ladder. He teaches those who seek salvation how to lay a firm foundation for struggles, how to be tapped and fight every passion, how to avoid demonic snares, and how to rise from the rudimental virtues to the heights of godlike love. John the latter came to Mount Sinai at age 16 and remained there, first as a novice under obedience, then as a recluse, and finally as captain of disciple Moses fell asleep under the shade of a large stone. John, in prayer in his cell, saw that his disciple was in danger and prayed to God for him. Later, when Moses returned, he fell on his knees and gave thanks to his spiritual father for saving him from certain death. He related how, entering, he heard John calling him, and he jumped up, and at that moment, the stone tumbled. Had he not jumped, the stone would have crushed him. John punished his died on March 30th, 606. Through his intercessions, O Christ God, have mercy upon us. Amen.
I shall open my mouth and deliver you with the Spirit, and I shall speak aloud to the Queen and Mother. I shall be seen joyfully singing the praises, and I shall be led to sing our waters.
As a living and copious mountain of Theotokos, do thou strengthen those who my praises, and our joint together in spiritual company for thy service, and in thy divine glory, make them worthy of crowns of glory.
He who sits
in halls
of glory, upon the throne of the Godhead, Jesus the Most High God, he with mighty hand can save those who cry to
I'm Thank you.
perfection.
Praise to the sound of the trumpet, praise to the psaltery and the harp. The angels proclaim the resurrection of the Lord. He frightened the guards, but to the veil he cried out, saying, I see the veil from under the dead. Verily he hath risen. Blessed and it is utterly overturned.
Travelers by sea,
by land and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and their salvation, and especially for those suffering for the faith, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and need, help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. All each remembrance are all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
To thee are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
To sing to thee, alleluia.
mercy upon us. Keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in your remembrance, our old Holy Immaculate, most blessed and glorious, the Son of Mary. All the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
That thou might deliver us from passion, by
and through ages of ages.
He swore to himself, saying, "Surely I will bless you and multiply you." And thus Abraham, having patiently endured, obtained the promise. Men indeed swear by a greater than themselves, and in all their disputes an oath is final for confirmation. So when God desired to show more convincingly to the heirs of the promise the unchangeable character of this purpose, he interposed with an oath, so that through two changeable things in which it is impossible that God should prove false, we who have fled for refuge might have strong encouragement to seize the hope set before us. We have this as a sure and steadfast anchor of the soul, a hope that enters into the inner shrine behind the curtain, where Jesus is gone as a forerunner on our behalf, having become a high priest forever after the order of Melchizedek.
Peace be to thee that reigneth,
and to thy spirit.
They were not able. And Jesus answered him, "O faithless generation, how long am I to be with you? How long am I to bear with you? Bring him to me." And they brought the boy to him, And when the spirit saw Jesus, immediately it convulsed the boy, and he fell on the ground and rolled about, foaming at the mouth. And Jesus asked his father, "How long has he had this?" And he said, "From childhood. And it has often cast him into the fire and into the water to destroy him. But if you can do anything, have pity on us and help us." And Jesus said to him, "If you can believe, all things are possible to him who believes." Immediately the father of the child cried out and said with tears, "Lord, I believe. Help my unbelief." And when Jesus saw that a crowd came running together, he rebuked the unclean spirit, saying to it, "You dumb and deaf spirit, I command you, come out of him and never enter him again." And after crying out and convulsing him terribly, it came out, and the boy was like a corpse, so that most of them said, "He is dead." But Jesus took him by the hand and lifted him up, and he arose. And when Jesus had entered the house, his disciples asked him privately, "Why could we not cast it out?" And Jesus said to them, "This kind cannot be driven out by anything but prayer and fasting." They went out from there and passed through Galilee, and Jesus would not have anyone know it, for he was teaching his disciples, saying to them, "The Son of Man will be delivered into the hands of men, and they will kill him, and after he is killed, he will rise on the third day."
Pulling off some, demons shooting others with arrows. And some people, when they have picked up this book and started reading it on their own without any kind of guide or spiritual father, they inevitably they wind up thinking that they're one of the poor souls being dragged off the ladder and falling through the doom, and they despair of their salvation. Because it's a hard book. It's written by people who expect to work hard, to struggle hard. And people who are not prepared or of that mindset can despair easily of their salvation. And this is, of course, tragic. But I dare say that you don't need to read St. John's book to necessarily fall into that same kind of despair on your own, to feel like, boy, you know, I'm not even sure that I'm on the right path. I'm not sure, well, we know that orthodoxy is the right path, but maybe we say, I'm just not very good at it. Many Orthodox faithful, perhaps most Orthodox, have known the deep discouragement by their own many failures to simply live out our faith, to make the sort of progress toward holiness that they expect they should have in their lives by now. Sometimes we wonder if we are still on the ladder, or, you know, maybe falling in the opposite direction. But I realize that you all have no idea what I'm talking about. You've never felt like everybody else is making progress in the faith except for you. You never felt like a kid in Pee Wee football running towards the wrong end zone. You know? You've never failed even once to make good on your repentance and to truly better your way of life. You've never had to confess the same thing twice, three times, 27 times, 143, you know. You've never struggled to find the motivation to get out of bed, come to church, to say your prayers, or even to lift a single finger to save your own soul. You've never used the expression, I am a bad Orthodox, right? No one ever here, except, unless you're talking about me, but by yourself. Not only a bad Orthodox, but possibly the worst ever. You know, yeah, we have a tendency to feel as if somehow we got left behind. Isn't that true? You know, you look at that ladder and you think, I know I'm not the guy at the top. I guess maybe I'm the guy at the bottom. I don't know. And it's kind of funny, you know, because this book that is supposed to be so inspirational and has helped so many monastics become saints, and even regular Orthodox faithful who have been able to apply aspects of it to one degree or another have benefited greatly. And I would dare say the whole world has benefited because this book is in the world. But we're not always comforted. I mean, people love the idea of ladders. You ever notice that? I mean, all the time you hear people talking about climbing up, you know, talking about people climbing the corporate ladder, one stab in the back at a time, you know, so going up. Others have climbed the ladder out of poverty into riches. You know, it's the kind of thing you hear on Oprah. I mean, we love upward mobility. We higher means better, richer, happier. And even our popular Christian preachers promise that if you'll buy their books and apply their principles, you will climb the ladder to prosperity, to power, to reaching your fullest potential. It all sounds so good, except for those who are left behind, who, for somehow, it doesn't work. And in the Orthodox Church, sometimes we're tempted to think Orthodoxy is not working for me, although I think most of us would say, I'm not really working for it. But let me tell you something. Tell you something about ladders. They go both ways. You know, you can go up a ladder, you can go down a ladder. We assume that their only purpose is to go upward. That up is good and down is bad, but that's not always true. What if you have to get down somewhere, to the basement, down into the tank, down into wherever it is you need to go to do what you need to do? Then a ladder is good. That's a lot better than jumping, you know? Sometimes you have to climb down to get to where you need to go. And haven't we also heard stories about drunks, you know, or addicts of some kind, who had to hit bottom before they finally came to their senses. And we think of that as a good thing. We don't like to see anybody, you know, splat but sometimes it has to happen because of whatever, human delusion, pride, misplaced, you know, whatever. I mean, we just, sometimes people just have to reach a point of almost desperation in their life before things turn around, before they reach upwards to God. Prodigal son, classic example. He had to climb all the way down life's ladder from being a rich kid who had it all to being the servant of swine. He was a pig waiter. He had to care for them. They were his masters. He had servants. Now he was the servant. But then he came to his senses and he cried out to his father for mercy. And that's what happened. You know, and ladders go both up and down. And you know, here's the thing too. God is at both ends. You know, that's, maybe our icon doesn't depict that. But God is at both ends. He's up at the top to greet the strugglers who've made it. He's down at the bottom for those who have splat and hit rock bottom. You know, if you've been coming to Great Compline, you've heard the beautiful prayer of Manassas, which I think is a good example of what I like to call our penitential prayers of Great Lent. It says in part, "My sins are more in number than the sands of the sea. My transgressions are multiplied. And I am not worthy to look up into the height of heaven for the multitude of my iniquities. I cannot lift up my head by reason of my sins. I have not kept thy commandments, and I have multiplied detestable things." It's true. It's not exaggeration, it's not hyperbole, it's not metaphor. When we look honestly at our lives, we see that we're not just kind of sinners. We really are sinful people with sinful desires. And very often we do not even, I mean, we give lip service to God, but we don't service sincerely. And we feel guilty. And I don't know, I guess we look at a prayer like this and we think, yeah, that describes where I'm at, but surely he wasn't that way, you know. Why would we assume that? Why can't we assume this man was sincere, that he was truly, in fact he was, if you read, you know, he's the king of Judah, stories in the Old Testament. But yeah, he came to this point where maybe you would say he hit bottom in his life, like Hezekiah and so many others. And how does this prayer end? And the stories of so many is with the ultimate resignation that all is lost, right? The guy just said, well, that's it. I'm a sinner. I can't even lift up my eyes to heaven. I'm just messing, right? A sensible abandoning of all hope. No, not at all. It wraps up, as do all of our penitential prayers. Thou wilt save me that I am unworthy, according to thy great mercy, and I will praise thee henceforth all the days of my life. That's not a surprise ending either, because like I say, all of our penitential prayers end this same way. You read them over and over, even, you know, Psalm 51. It's, I am desperately, truly, deeply sinful. Do we identify with that, or do we only sort of kind of identify with that, you know? I think there's this tendency sometimes we look at that and say, he's exaggerating. But it's, you know, we don't want to look at it that way. We want to believe that a person could acknowledge the full depth and breadth of their sin, the you know, the depravity of their soul, and have hope in God. Every saint had two things in common. One, they saw themselves as chief of sinners. No one is worse than I. And they always had unshakable hope in God, who saves the sinners. You can't have one without the other. If you have this hope in God without a recognition of your sinfulness, then you're just arrogant and you don't take your repentance seriously. If you have this acknowledgement of your sinfulness but no hope in God, then you're despairing and lost. You have the both. But we need to develop the both. The confession, a true confession, that I can say honestly before God, I have sinned, O Lord, I have sinned. And I am not even worthy to lift my eyes to heaven, but thou wilt save me because of thy mercy and thy goodness. Make an example of me. Show the world that yes, I can save the worst human being that ever crawled the face of this earth. Father Michael Ray. Could it be that the one thing that our spiritual efforts, or even our lack of efforts, show us is that we really aren't very good at making ourselves holy? You know, we can't pull ourselves up by our bootstraps. All these prayers, they end in the same way. All hope in ourselves, utterly exhausted, and every hope in God, renewed. God will save me. Jesus Christ came to save the sinners. Are we qualified? Oh my, yes. The idea of making your way up the holiness ladder sounds great until you try it, you know. Then it comes down to constant failure. I can't even keep my prayer rule. I can't even get up on Sunday and drag myself to church on time. I forget about God all the time, you know. What's wrong? What's wrong with us? Do we just need to keep trying harder? You know, force ourselves more and more? Well, yeah, probably a little bit. But maybe for us, the way up is to go down. Maybe we need to learn some humility first. You know, part of the reason why we struggle is because we're not really lovers of God or seekers of God. If we love God, then it would be no problem, right? We would gladly pray. But by trying and failing so often to live the Christian life, maybe what we learn ultimately is a little bit of humility before God. Like the prodigal, can we come to our senses and realize that our Father's love is our only salvation? We simply need to trust in Him, respond to Him. You know, I think that's actually the message that's sort of within the ladder of divine ascent. Even the most diligent monk will come to find at some point that everything depends on the love of God and His unfailing mercy toward us. No matter how hard you work, you're not saved by your works. You're saved by God who loves you. And it's a funny thing that for the saint, no matter how many and terrible his sins, how great and wonderful his virtues, it doesn't matter, those things don't even count in his sight. My sins or my virtues, they don't matter. I only see the grace of God and place all my hope in the salvation of the Lord. And this is where our hope needs to be. We may never succeed in making ourselves better Christians. I just want to say that, you know, because all the time I'm up here saying, push, 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 do this, do that, you know. And we should. I mean, we don't want to say, may sin abound, or may sin increase that grace may abound. We do want to labor in our repentance. We do want to try to force ourselves to do our prayers and come to church and pay our tithes and offerings, remember the poor, all these kinds of things. We should do this. Refrain from terrible sins, yes. But it's like, even if we feel like I'm not fundamentally changing, I'm doing these things, but I'm still me, still kind of ugly. Well, so what? What does that matter, really? As long as we're doing the right thing, as long as we're in the place where we need to be, we shouldn't be measuring our own progress. Like, how many rungs have I climbed? You know, it doesn't matter. We need to place our hope in God, not in our performance. Place your hope in God. He will not disappoint. You know, our sins and the scriptures and the prayers of the saints teach, all of our sins, pretty ugly stuff, made the world fall and die, and, you know, lions eat lambs and all that sort of thing. All of our sins are like a drop in the ocean of God's love. It's nothing. Stop feeling guilty and just try to better your way of life. And don't worry about your progress. Be faithful. Trust in God. We should always continue to do the best that we can. But realize that we will never receive any more or any less than what the grace of God gives us. He is our only hope and our salvation. And that is perhaps, I think, the best lesson to be learned on this Sunday of the matter. The glory of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us. Keep us, O God, by thy grace, wisdom.
Let it hardly always find thy might we may ascribe glory unto thee, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Nevertheless, we have a seat.
Remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. For the President of the United States and all civil authorities and our armed forces everywhere, the Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. For the Orthodox servants of God, especially for the Archpriest Wayne and his family, for Kevin and his family, for Lorraine, Sarah, the Deacon Rick, Elena, Peter, Nicole, John, Wanda, for Charlotte, Aubrey, Maggie, Sophia, Stacy, Christina, Nadia, and Angela, that they have mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, pardon, and remission of their sins. The Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. The Orthodox servants of God departed this life, and especially for all our loved ones whom we remember this morning, the Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
For the world, let
let us ask of the Lord. Time of our life in peace and repentance, for a Christian end to our life, painless, blameless, peaceful, and a good defense before the fearful judgment seat of Christ, let us ask of the Lord. Calling to remembrance our all holy immaculate, most blessed, glorious Lady Theotokos, the Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Together with that holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be to all.
And to thy Spirit.
Let us love one another, that with one accord we may confess.
Truly exists, Master, Lord God, Father Almighty, and Lord, it is truly
just and befitting the majesty of thy holiness that we should magnify thee, praise thee, bless thee, worship thee, give thanks unto thee, and glorify thee, the only truly existing God, and offer unto thee with contrite heart the spirit of humility, yes, our reasonable service. For thou art he that hath graciously bestowed upon us the knowledge of thy truth, and who is sufficient to speak of thy mighty acts, to make all thy praises to be heard, or to tell of all thy wonders at every season. O Master of all, Lord of heaven and earth, and of all creation, both visible and invisible, who sitteth upon the throne of glory and beholdest the depths, who art without beginning, invisible, incomprehensible, uncircumscribed, immutable, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, our great God and Savior, our hope, who is the image of thy goodness, the seal of equal type, in himself showing forth thee, the Father, the living Word, the true God, the wisdom before all ages, the light, sanctification, life, the true life, through whom the Holy Spirit was manifested, the Spirit of truth, the gift of adoption, the pledge of an inheritance to come, the first fruits of eternal good things, the life-giving power, the fountain of holiness, thy whom enabled every rational and intelligent creature to serve thee, and set up to thee perpetual praise, for all things are thy servants, yea, angels and archangels, thrones, dominions, principalities, authorities, powers, and the many-eyed cherubim praise thee. Round about thee stand the six-winged seraphim, and with twain they cover their faces, and with twain their feet, and with twain they fly, continually crying out to one another with unceasing praises, singing the triumphal hymn, shouting, proclaiming, and saying,
and he is left with us as memorials of his saving passions.
these things which he had spread forth according to his commandment. For when he was about to go forth, he was voluntary, and ever and memorable, and life created again, in the night in which he gave himself for the life of the world, took bread in his holy and spotless hands. And when he had shown it unto thee, his God and Father, and given thanks, and blessed it, and hallowed it, and broke it, he gave it to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, Take, eat, this is my body which is broken for you, for the remission of sins. Shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this in remembrance of me, for as often as you shall eat the bread and drink of the cup, you do proclaim my death and confess my resurrection. Wherefore, O Master, we also, having in remembrance the saving passion and life-giving cross, his 3 days burial and resurrection from the dead, his ascension into heaven and session at thy right hand, his God and Father, and his glorious and terrible second advent. Thine own of thine own we offer unto thee in behalf of all and for all. Graciously permitted to minister at that holy altar, not in your own righteousness, but we have the holy altar, but because of thy mercy, to bow and pray thy for our bones. Treasuries with every good thing, maintain their marriage bond in peace and concord, rear the infants, guide the young, support the aged, encourage the faint-hearted, collect the scattered and turn them from the wandering astray, and unite them to thy holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. Set at liberty those who are vexed by unclean spirits. Travel with those who journey by land and sea and air. Defend the widows, protect the orphans, free the captives, heal the sick, and those who are under trial, in the mines and exile, every tribulation, necessity, danger, remember, O God, all those who receive thy great loving kindness, and all those who love us and those who hate us, and those who have enjoyed us, unworthy though we be to pray for them. Be mindful, O Lord our God, of all thy people, and above them all pour out thy rich mercy, granting to all their petitions which are unto salvation. And those who we, through ignorance or forgetfulness or the multitude of names, have not remembered, do thou thyself remember, O God, and knowing the time of life and name of each, and knowest every man of you from his mother's womb. For thou, O Lord, art the helper of the helpless, the hope of the hopeless, the savior of the storm-tossed, the haven of the voyager, the healer of the sick. Be thou thyself all things to all men, O thou who knowest every man, his petition, his dwelling place and his need. Deliver, O Lord, this city and every city and countryside from famine, plague, earthquake, flood, fire, sword, invasion of enemies, and civil war. Among the first be mindful, O Lord, of our father and metropolitan Joseph, whom do thou grant unto thy holy churches in peace, safety, honor, health, and length of days, and likely the abiding of word of thy truth. Pardon me every transgression, both voluntary and involuntary, and withhold not because of my sins the grace of thy Holy Spirit from these gifts here spread forth. Be mindful, O Lord, the priesthood, the diaconate, the Christ, and every priestly rank, and put not to confusion any one of us who stand about thy holy altar. Visit us with thy loving kindness, O Lord, manifest thyself unto us in thy rich compassions, grant us temperate and healthful seasons. Give gentle showers upon the earth unto fruitfulness. Bless the crown of the year by beneficence. Make the schisms of the churches to cease. Quench the ragings of hostile nations. Speedily destroy by the might of thy Holy Spirit uprisings of heresy. Receive us all into thy kingdom, making us children unto light and unto day. And grant unto us thy peace and thy love, O Lord our God, for all things hast thou given unto us. Grant us with one mouth and one heart to glorify and praise that all holy and majestic name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
And the mercies of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ be with you all.
Sanctified, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That our God who loveth mankind, receiving them upon his holy, heavenly, and ideal altar, for an odor of spiritual fragrance, will send down upon us in return his divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Asking for the unity of the faith and the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Who art in heaven,
Jesus Christ, to the glory.
the fear of God, with faith and love draw near.
Thank you.
O God, save thy people and bless thine inheritance.
Be my
mercy come upon you through his grace and love to his mankind, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to thee, O Christ, our God, and our hope, glory to thee.
Of the honorable, glorious prophet, forerunner, and Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, and all honorable apostles, of our father among the saints, Basil the Great, Archbishop of Caesarea in Cappadocia's divine liturgy we have now celebrated, of the holy, glorious, and right victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, of Saint Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Adam, of our venerable and God-bearing father, John Climacus of Sinai, author of the latter, of our father among the saints, Cyril, patriarch of Jerusalem, the martyrs Trophimus and Eucharpus of Nicomedia, and those with them, Nikolai Belomorovich, bishop of Sichak, and who labored in America, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all the saints, have mercy upon us and save us, for as much as he is good, your love is mankind. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Amen.
So at this time, we will have our monthly memorial. Those of our loved ones have passed during the month of March and years previous.
Is our God, always, now, and ever, and up to ages of ages. Amen. Holy God, holy, mighty, holy, immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy, mighty, holy, immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy, mighty, holy, immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and up to ages of ages. Amen. O Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, cleanse us from our sins. Master, pardon our iniquities. Holy God, visit and heal our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, our true God, who hath dominion over the living and the dead, through the intercessions of his all-immaculate and all-blameless Holy Mother, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, and of all the saints, establish the souls of his servants whom we've remembered here this morning, departed this life, in his holy mansions, and number them among the just, and have mercy upon us for as much as he is good and loveth mankind. May thy memory be eternal, O our ever memorable brethren, who are worthy of blessedness. Christ our God, have mercy on us and save us.